How do you get started with memoQ? Coming up. Hello and welcome back to the Freelanceverse. Thanks so much, first of all, for the support of last week's video about the traps that freelancers should look out for. The support has been amazing, reception has been amazing, so thank you very much for that. Today I would like to start a new series kind of on my channel where I talk about tools and how I use certain tools, because I get a lot of comments and messages about, you know, how to use this cut tool, how to use this productivity tool, etc. So today's video is going to be about memoQ, because memoQ is by far the tool I use the most, so I thought it's a good way to start. So I will show you basically the basics, yeah, how to get started with memoQ, how to import a package, how to translate the package, how to create the project, how to create the translation memory as well, maybe how to align translations after you're done, depending on how much time we have. But yeah, so today's video is going to be very practical, very hands-on on the screen. So let's switch to that. Hope you enjoy. All right, here we are. This is memoQ, the dashboard. Obviously, I have to blur this screen because here it basically displays all my projects that I'm working on or have been working on for clients. So there is probably a big blur box for you guys now. As you see, this is the dashboard. Here you get four very big buttons that basically show you the most important features of memoQ. Everything is also here in the titles, but these four things, I always use these buttons because they are big and nice, and it's very quick access. So what we'll definitely do is create a new project without a template. I don't think we will do from a template because that's a bit for later. For example, if you always work for the same clients again, you can create a template and then you can just create a new project from template, choose the client, and everything is already set. You know all the settings. I will show you how to check out a project from memoQ server. I can't really show you a lot because, of course, the servers I'm working with are from clients and I am not allowed to leak the servers, otherwise I would have a big problem. But I'm going to show you as much as I can. And translate the package, I can also show you what this means, I think. But most of the time we will spend on create a new project without a template. I think I'm going to use the Word file that I've used for the $5 versus $50 translation video, at least an adaptation of it. I will probably adapt it a bit so that there are a few repetitions in there, so I can show you the repetition tool and the auto-propagation tool, etc. So let's get started by create a new project without template. And there is the first pop-up, as I just mentioned. So memoQ works a lot with these windows. So in this new memoQ project pop-up, you have to enter all the settings and names of the project. So this has nothing to do yet with the document. This is about the project in itself. So you create a project in memoQ and then you upload documents in this project. So the name of the project is quite important because this is how you organize yourself within the tool. So make sure you have a system here. What I do is I always type the number of the project, my project number. Now let's just choose 1111, and then I do underscore and I type the name of the project underscore the client. So let's do test underscore freelancers. You can also fill all these things down here in, especially the client. I always fill in here because then in the translation memory you will have entries, and it's good to see next to the entry for what client you worked on this job. The source languages, you see it suggests probably the one you use the most. You can open it and change it. I'm usually using English, the general English, and then either German for Germany and German for Switzerland. Yes, and the rest, I don't change anything. You could even, you know, add a deadline and then it gives you a little pop-up when something is due. It's quite a nice reminder. It depends if I have this in another document or tool. So we click on next. Now it says translation documents, right? So this is where we import the files that we will translate in the project. You can import it normally or import it with options. I almost never use import with options. This is really for very complicated projects. For example, if you have PowerPoints, certain slides should be hidden and not imported, for example, then you can do this in the options. But yeah, I almost never do that. If I have weird documents, I usually translate them outside of a cut tool and then only import the finished translation to align it for my translation memory. So now let's just import a normal project for now, a normal document, sorry. So I click on import, look for my documents here on the desktop, and I click open. So now it's importing the document And not only this, it's also segmenting it into different segments, so you don't have to do that. Usually segments are sentences. It works in a column format, as you will see in a second. And then every sentence is a segment, and it's very good for the eye, you know, it's very nice overview. Let's click on next. Now this is the translation memories. The ones you see are the ones that I've already generated, right? And it's not all of them, this is only the ones that match the language combination, English to German. There is one that I collect everything I ever translated in, I collect into this one. There is one for German Germany and one for German Switzerland. This helps me to just kind of have a summary of all the things I ever translated into one TM. I rarely ever use it to actually work from it because you don't, you know, there is any type of context is in there. So also in an IT project, stuff from maybe, I don't know, dog food or whatever that I ever translated would still show up in this context. And context matters a lot, as you know. And so it's better to create a new one for every single project that you do. I usually delete them when I don't use them anymore. So that's why there are not a lot here. It's quite organized. They're the biggest clients I have a translation memory and also overall the languages. So when I import a new document, I would create a new one here for this specific project. Here again, I type the name for this translation memory. The languages are already in. And all the settings are default, you don't need to change them. So let's click OK. So this is now the working and the master translation memory from this project. Working means it's the one that memoQ saves translations in while you're working on it. And master means it's also the one that at the end, when you're completely finished and you click on deliver project or finish project, it updates all the instances translation memory. So the master only gets populated in the end when all the translation is exactly how you want it. The working gets updated on the go, so also with things that you will still change later. You can have working and master both in the same one, but you can also assign the master to, like for example, now I'm also gonna choose the one I choose for all my projects, right? I also click on this and then I set this as master, set as master. So now my overall translation memory is the master. The one I created for this specific project is the working. I click on next, then Termbases. Termbase is, you just always have to create one for every project. So I do the same, 1111. And then you have to choose the languages. And this is not so important, Termbases, especially when you work on your own. If you get the Termbase from a client, it's important to import it here. But if you work on your own, you just need to create one here. And I click on finish. And everything gets created and imported. So now you see we are in the project home overview. In the project home, you see translations. There you see our document, letter questionnaire, term bases, also settings, live docs. I think where it worked before, we used this for like reference material. So if you have other documents that support your translations, you can upload them here and the translator can read them. That's more for agencies that use the server-based tool. For yourself, you won't use LiveDocs. And you have the translation here. This icon means that the translation is in progress. If you're finished, there will be two, what are they called? Ticks? Yeah, two ticks. And here you see the progress bar. The translation, 0%, review 1, 0%, review 2, 0%. Now let's work on it. We are already quite a long way into the video. I wanted to make this rather short, but let's go for it. So I open letter questionnaire. All right, as you can see, it's a very short text. I just prepared this. On the left, you see the English source. On the right, you see what you can translate. And on bottom here, you see a preview of the document, what it will look like in Word. Of course, this is a rather standard document, so there's not a lot to see, but sometimes it's important when there are images or arrows or something or bold italics. It's cool to see it here, the preview. In this one, it's not really important now, but so, and then here you can actually translate. Once you wrote your translation, memoQ works a lot with colors. So the orange colors means you're currently editing it. Gray means it's not edited yet. So if I confirm this segment, if I'm finished translating, I click Control Enter, and you see it confirms the segment, it becomes green here, and there is a tick here. And what I want to show you quickly, I'm just gonna copy paste here the translation that one of the translators from Fiverr wrote for this segment. I click on Control Enter to save it, right? And then down here, I have a similar sentence. I just changed a little bit. And then you see already on the right side, you could have this automatically populated with this suggestion. I decided to turn this off because it kind of distracts me. I rather have the results in the right side suggesting to me. So this is the translation memory, right? So we just translated the first sentence, and then the segment 5, the only difference in the end, it says for 40 years instead of for such a long time. So the translation memory says, hey, you know what? I found this sentence that you've already translated before, but it's not 100% match. It says it's an 83% match. So this tells me, okay, 83%, it's probably useful for me. I can probably copy some of it, but not all of it. It's not 100% match, right? If it was 100 or even 101% match, which is when the context is even correct, then it would already populate it into my memo queue and it would already be green. I wouldn't have to do anything. I'll show you this in a second. Here I can now decide to use this suggestion. This is suggestion 1, as you can see here. So if I click, I think it's Control 1. Yes, Control 1, then it takes result 1 from the translation memory suggestions. And it's now in here. But I need to make sure that I change so lange, so such a long time, seit 40 Jahren, for 40 years. Just quickly show you what happens when it's 100% match. Again, I copy what the translator wrote for this one. You already see here this green, this is a repetition. This is a repetition, so I already know that somewhere in the document, of course it's very small, so I know it's these two, but somewhere in the document this has already been, this is a repetition, it's already been written. So if I translate this once, then it immediately copies it here as well. Auto propagation, so I don't even need to, when I get to this segment, it's already confirmed. 0%, I don't have to do anything, it's already checked, confirmed. All right, that's it. And then always save your projects, that's very important. And in the end, when everything is done, you can go back to the project home, you can right click on the document, and you can export it if you want, right? You can export a Word file. You can always export it the same way that you imported it. So I imported now a Word file. So if I go on export store path, it will just export also a Word file. And once you do this, once you finish the project, it will also populate the master translation memory that you chose in the beginning. You can always close project home here and you get back to the dashboard. And now you can actually see this is the project that I made. It's local, it's not on a server, it's on my computer. This is the name, size of the project, it's almost completed. And now to just quickly, we don't have much more time, just quickly show you how the memoQ server thing works. I think I mentioned it on the channel before. If a company wants to give you a license for a specific project, only for the duration of the project, they can give you, and also it's just more convenient for them, honestly, even if you have a license, they can give you a project on their server. So I would click on this, another thing opens. I have to, of course, to blur all these. There's a drop-down menu of all the servers that I'm using for different clients. They have an internet address, basically, a web address. And then you can click on the tick here. And once you click on there, it loads all the projects that they currently share with you on their server. You can open it and then it immediately opens the project to translate in, right? They take care of the translation memory, the live docs, the translation bases, the settings, everything. For you, you just open this from the server, you work directly on there, you confirm everything. The matches you find are from their huge translation memory from the specific client, right? So it's not, the memory is not local on your computer. You can then still add your local translation memory to the project if you want to, but the one you're using as a working one is from the client. And once you finish it, you deliver it, you don't have to export anything. You just click in memoQ on deliver now, and then it goes straight to the client and you are done, basically. All right, I think that's it for today. Maybe this is a part one of memoQ. I'm not sure I could show you much more, but the video gets too long otherwise. So I hope this gives you an idea of how to start off with memoQ. I think it's the best CAD tool. If you want to invest in one, I would go for this one. Let me just check what it costs, actually. I just found my last invoice that I paid in November 2020. So this goes until November 2021, and it was 124 euros. So it looks like, yeah, about 124 euros per year. It's an investment, of course, but I use this almost every day, so it's definitely a tool that I need. And of course, it's a business tool, so you can deducted from the taxes 100%. All right, that's all I have for today. Let me know in the comments if you like these videos, very practical, very hands-on, and I will do more tools in the future, maybe a part two of memoQ as well. Otherwise, I see you next week with, I think it's Q&A time next week, yeah, probably the next Q&A of the series. I see you then, bye-bye.